Now, let's formally introduce the first TD algorithm in this lecture. What does this algorithm do? It estimates the state value. Whose state value? The state value of a given policy pi. Let's look at why we need to estimate the state value. In fact, once I estimate the state value, I can do policy evaluation. By combining this with policy improvement, I can find the optimal policy. But let's look at the first step, how to use the TD algorithm to do policy evaluation. First, we need to emphasize that TD algorithms often refer to a broad class of algorithms. All the algorithms we discuss today are TD algorithms, including Q-learning. However, the TD algorithm we are about to introduce is the most classic and basic one. It is designed to estimate state value and has a simple expression. Now let's introduce the TD algorithm. How will I introduce it? First, I will present the algorithm, then I will analyze it in detail from various aspects. The TD algorithm requires data instead of models. What kind of data does it require? Here it is. It can be called data or experience, and it can be written in a long sequence like this. Starting from S0, I get R1 and transition to S1, and this continues until time t, where starting from ST, I get RT plus 1 and transition to ST plus 1, and so on. This long sequence can also be written in a set form, where the curly braces represent a set. The elements of this set are inside the small parentheses, each containing three elements, ST, RT plus 1, and ST plus 1. Both of these representations can be called experience. The experience data is generated by the given policy pi. Based on the policy, I can generate such a set of data. So, what does the TD algorithm do with this data? It estimates the state value of policy pi. This is the expression of the TD algorithm. Now let me explain in detail. There is a symbol, VS. What is S? It is any state in the state space. For every state in the state space, there is a corresponding V. This V approximates V pi S, which is the state value of S. V at time t has a subscript t, representing the estimated value at time t. At time t plus 1, it becomes the estimated value at time t plus 1. In this equation, you also see ST. What is ST? It is the state visited at time t within an episode. An agent can visit only one state at a time. What does this algorithm do? It consists of two parts. Let's look at the first part. At time t, I am in state ST. I have some data, and what do I need to do? I need to update the value corresponding to ST. The value at time t is vt, and after updating, the value becomes vt plus 1. How do we update it? We update vt by subtracting this long term, which I will explain in detail later. Now let's look at the second equation. The second equation states that at time t, I visited state st. Therefore, all other states were not visited, and their v remains unchanged. So, vt plus 1 equals vt. This is the TD algorithm. Next, let's look at the first equation in detail. The second equation is very simple, so we do not need to analyze it. In practice, you usually do not see the second equation because it is omitted. However, I still want to write it out to show you that this equation exists mathematically. For the first equation, I have added some annotations to make it clearer. First, on the left side is Vt plus 1. It is the new estimate of the V value for St. It equals the sum of two parts on the right side. The first part is the current estimate or the old estimate. Then, we add a correction term. In the correction term, alpha t is a coefficient for st. In the brackets, there are several terms with specific names. Let me introduce them one by one. First, there is rt plus 1 plus gamma vt, st plus 1. This is called the TD target. Why is it called the TD target? I will explain it shortly. Essentially, it means that vt is expected to become closer to the target. There is an error between the current value and the TD target. This error is called the TD error. How do we interpret the TD error? I will explain it in detail later. In summary, the new estimate is obtained by adding a correction term to the old estimate. Next, let's explain in detail what the TD target and TD error are. Understanding these two concepts is crucial for understanding the TD algorithms. I hope everyone can pay attention. First, why is VT bar called the TD target? This algorithm aims to steer VST towards VT bar. That is, at the next time step, VST will be closer to VT bar. Therefore, VT bar is its target value. This is why it is called the TD target. Now, let's explain using the following math. This is the algorithm we provided earlier, and VT bar is the TD target. Next, I will make a modification to the algorithm. Subtract the VT bar from both sides. The left side becomes VT plus 1 minus VT bar. The right side becomes this VT minus VT bar and this VT minus VT bar with a coefficient. After some rearrangement, we get the following equation. The left side is VT plus 1 minus VT bar, and the right side is VT minus VT bar with a coefficient of 1 minus alpha T. What does this equation tell us? It tells us how the difference between VT and VT bar changes. This is at time T and this is at time T plus 1. We will see that VT plus 1 is actually closer to VT bar. Why? First, take the absolute value of both sides of the equation. The coefficient alpha t is a small positive number, so 1 minus alpha t is a number greater than 0 but less than 1. Thus, we get the following inequality. The absolute value of Vt plus 1 minus Vt bar is less than or equal to the absolute value of Vt minus Vt bar. What does this imply? It implies that at the next time step, the distance between Vst and Vt bar is smaller. So, this algorithm drives Vst towards Vt bar. This is the overall idea. If you understand this, you will have a clear understanding of what the TD algorithm is doing. Next, let's discuss the concept of TD error. How should we interpret the TD error? I have already written it here. Delta is V minus this term. First, we need to understand that it is an error between two quantities, Vst and the right-hand term. These two quantities are actually at two different time steps. This is at time t, and this is at time t plus 1. It involves two time steps. This is why it is called temporal difference. This is a straightforward interpretation. Moreover, the TD error not only describes the error between two time steps, but also describes the error between Vt and Vpi. Vpi is the value we want to estimate, and Vt is our current estimate. This delta t can describe the difference between these two values. Why? First, let me summarize in one sentence. When Vt equals Vpi, delta t should be 0. Conversely, if delta t is not 0, it indicates that Vt does not equal Vpi. This is the conclusion. Let's see why it is true. First, based on delta t, we define delta pi t. What is delta pi t? It is obtained by replacing V with Vpi in the equation. Why? Because we ultimately want V to converge to Vpi. So now I replace V with Vpi and see what happens. I take the expectation of delta pi t and it equals Vpi st minus ert plus 1 plus gamma Vpi st plus 1. I believe everyone is familiar with this. This is actually equal to 0. Why? At time t, the state value of state st is equal to the expectation of the immediate reward plus the value of Vpi at the next state. From this equation, we know that when Vt equals Vpi, delta t becomes delta pi t, and delta t should be 0, of course, in the sense of expectation. Conversely, if delta t is not 0, it indicates that there is still a gap between Vt and Vpi. So delta t can illustrate the inconsistency between Vt and Vpi. Finally, TD error can also be interpreted as innovation. What is innovation? It is new information. Suppose I have an estimate of Vpi, and this estimate might be inaccurate. Then I get a new experience. I link this experience with my estimate and calculate the error. I find out that there is an error. The existence of this error indicates that my current estimate is inaccurate. I can use this error to improve my current estimate. This is new and useful information. We have just introduced TD target and TD error. Next, we will introduce some basic properties of the TD algorithms. First, let's look at what it can and cannot do. What exactly does this TD algorithm do? It estimates the state value for a given policy. So the TD algorithm only estimates the state value and performs policy evaluation. What can't it do? It cannot estimate action values, nor can it directly generate optimal policies. However, based on this algorithm, we will soon extend to obtain a series of TD algorithms that can estimate action values. Combined with the policy improvement step, they can eventually obtain optimal policies. Although the TD algorithm we introduced just now is very simple, it is very fundamental. When introducing TD algorithms for the first time, we cannot introduce a very complex algorithm, as it would be difficult for the readers to grasp the core idea. With this TD algorithm as a foundation, you will find that the subsequent algorithms are very similar and easy to understand.